Well, just to get started, my name is Andy Townsend. I've been with Kaplan for about 6 years. I teach a lot of different tests with them. GRE is my main one, but I also do GMAT, I do LSAT, I do some SAT. I as well was a Kaplan student when I started preparing for grad school. I have a bachelor's in history from Virginia Tech, and I'm finishing off a doctorate in international studies at Old Dominion. I've actually just moved up to Charlottesville, so I'm actually talking from up there instead of down there, but I just have to finish writing a big old paper. So I've been through the whole thing that all you guys are hopefully just about to embark on. If you have any specific questions about my personal experience or anything else at any time, please don't hesitate, and I'll make sure and leave my contact information at the end of the presentation so everyone can see that. Does anybody have any questions before we get started and into this? Well, if not, let's take a look at our presentation here. We're talking about path to grad school, basically getting ready to transition from your bachelor's degree into a graduate degree before you actually go out and get into the job market. Now, unlike the undergraduate degree, which I think a lot of folks kind of come into this idea that I'm going to college, but I don't really have any idea what I'm going to do. I'm just going to go, and that's where I'm going to really figure things out. Grad school, you really can't treat like that. For one, it's the expense. For two, you know, you're normally on your own dime. For three, there's normally not near as much time. You know, most master's programs are just 2 years, so it's not as though you have a huge quantity. And also, they're much more focused. When you talk about a graduate program, yeah, there are core classes that you're going to have to take, but most of the cores are still much more specialized than courses you've had to take as an undergraduate. So you really want to have a plan before you ever really start getting and moving forward. So let's talk the first thing about why. Why do you want to go to graduate school? And there's a lot of different reasons. I mean, the biggest one, increased knowledge. You just want to know more. But the big point for a lot of people is just jobs. Employment stability, being able to earn more in a potential job, having more opportunities. And the last part there says increase your marketability. That's just that for every job, as competitive as the job market is out there, you want to have something that you're going to stand out versus someone else who's applying to a similar job. And if you have an advanced degree, that's going to give you a huge leg up because it's going to have the demonstrated knowledge and excellence in a field as opposed to someone else who's also applying to that position. So when we start doing this, you want to oh goodness, lost picture. Sorry. So once you get into this, one of the big things you want to think about before you even start down the path of graduate school is to think about an end destination. Where do you want to go? Because that's going to determine what sort of degree you need, whether it's just a master's, whether it's a professional degree, whether it's a doctorate. You know, because some people just won't need a doctorate for what they need. They might just need that master in order to go forward with it. So you really want to investigate your options before, investigate your employment options before you ever get into the process of applying to graduate school. It should really be about the first thing you take a look at. Any questions about that? I have lost picture, by the way. I can't see anyone in the thing. Like I've got, it says Byron Barber. Looks like somebody might have tried to start their camera or something like that.
They may have turned their cameras off.
Okay.
Do you just see like a gray face?
Yes, there. Now it's back in.
It shifts to who's talking. So that's why you see the room now. So it's kind of voice automated. But the gray faces, it's because they probably turned their camera off. They didn't want you to see them.
Okay, good. Now I just, all of a sudden I lost. All I can see is my screen. I couldn't see anybody there. So does anybody have any questions about this? When you talk about the fact that you need to be focused on your job prospects first, that's really need where you kind of start things, this planning that process. Well, if not, let's go to the next piece, which is once you decide, okay, I'm going to go get this job, what do you need? Do you need a master or do you need a doctorate? Big difference between these two fields, these two degrees, is the intensity. And that is to say that with a master's degree, it's going to take you 1 to 3 years, depending on the program, depending on the particular degree that you're going after. You'll still normally have to write a thesis at the end of that, a paper describing some specialized piece of research. But it's going to be far more intense than your undergraduate education was. But then the doctorate takes it even to another step. You're going to be an expert in your field, and you're going to produce original research on a topic before you finish. That's the point of the doctoral dissertation.
Andy, somebody, hold on 1 second.
I've got some people, I think. Yeah.
Mute your microphones, please.
Yeah, I'm getting a lot of feedback from some folks out there. So if you could please mute your microphones. Anybody help me out here?
Andrew
Monroe, I think your microphone is on. If you could mute that, please, I'd appreciate it.
What an idiot.
Could everyone attending at home please mute their microphones?
Yeah, somebody's got their TV on or something. I can barely hear over myself. Hello? I can't hear or see anyone right now. I can. Oh, wait a minute. Okay, I cannot hear. Hello?
Give me 1 second, Andy. I'm trying to get it taken care of from a tech support standpoint so that everybody
sounds
gets
good.
Muted.
It's just, every once in a while when it goes to the gray thing, I can't see anything. And just let me know when you would like me to continue.
Hey, Andy, we've gotten everybody's mics muted. I'm not sure why you're not seeing. I can see you, and I can see the students, and the students
it
can see you.
It comes in and out. Like when you speak just now or something like that, it'll go. But if it clicks off, I can't see anything in the video window. Like it'll show is the little gray silhouette.
So you don't see your PowerPoint presentation?
No, I mean, I can see my PowerPoint on my own screen. I'm talking about the video feed of the center there at ODU.
Oh, it's voice activated. So when you start talking and I stop, it's going to switch. But we can see you.
Okay. Well, I'll just keep on with it then and let me know. And I'll ask for questions at any point and see if we can keep going.
Yeah. And I will make sure to chat or to speak any questions in that we may get.
Excellent. Wonderful.
Okay. Thanks. Sorry about that.
All right. Quite all right. It's a wonderful modern world we live in. So we were talking real quick about the master's versus the doctorate degree. Master's, again, 1 to 3 years in study. Doctorate's 5 to 7 at least years of study, sometimes more depending on how long your dissertation actually takes to produce. Normally it's about 4 years of classes and then another 2 years or so of writing a dissertation. So, But again, this is something you really want to research beforehand. Not all jobs, even within a field, given field, are going to require a doctorate. I mean, a lot of fields out there, a master's is really what you need in order to accomplish your career goals. But that being said, advanced degrees are something that are becoming more and more important in today's society. They're just the rate of people who have them are increasing. And it's a trend that we've seen, especially with the downturn in the economy. A lot of folks who couldn't find work just went back to school. They got on some student loans and they went back and started working again, or started taking classes again. So now that the economy is starting to pick up, they're back out in that job market, the numbers are even more increased than what they see here. These charts are a little bit older. So you want to be able to compete against these people as best you can. You really need that advanced degree in a lot of fields to be able to do that. One of the big things you want to be thinking about when you get onto the graduate path is then also how you're going to pay for it. With master's degrees, there tend to be fewer opportunities to take, whether it's an assistantship or a grant or some sort of other money that you will then not end up having to pay for. They tend to reserve a lot of those scholarships, as the chart shows here, for the doctoral students. And this is, you know, whether you want to work for the university, a lot of times it'll be like as a research position, either as a teaching assistant, something like that. And a big part of that will be then like a tuition deferment. So in return for working for the department, they'll defer all your tuition for that. And the big thing to think about this, though, as well, is that while it says 80% of a doctoral, the cost of going for a doctoral degree might be covered, you are in school for a lot longer. So that 20% of the total cost might be closer to the real dollar amount in the master's degree. This is something you really want to investigate before you get for it, whether it's scholarships, how does the school handle this sort of information, and it's something that really pays off to do a lot of research on as early as possible. Any questions about that?